NHITC Sport. Alright, so the Premier League predictions was this game week 10. Alright then, let's see how bad these are. Right, let's go. Leicester versus Arsenal. Here's a question for Arsenal fans. Do you feel something sliding down your leg? No, that's not your uncle's hand. That's last night's bangers and mash. And you know what? You're right to be scared. You're right to be so petrified by this trip to Leicester City that you've lost all control of your bowels. Because the last time you beat Leicester City in front of their own fans was September 2015. That's nearly 3,000 days. Christ above, Alexis Sanchez scored a hat-trick in that match. Nowadays, he's about as useful as a chocolate scrotum. I know you beat them 3-1 at the King Power in February, but does anyone really count what happened last season? I mean, a bit different when you're playing in front of three stewards, one of whom is too busy swiping Tinder for fat old men in her seat. I mean, to be fair, both Leicester and Arsenal are now back in form. I mean, sort of. Let's not forget Brendan Rodgers hasn't overseen a clean sheet since mid-August. And don't you dare count the League Cup win at Millwall. You stopped Matt Bradshaw scoring a goal. Oh, well done. We'll just ignore the fact that he's about as imposing as a buttered slice of birthday cake. You know what? I think this will be a good game. Manchester United utterly chewed to death in the stadium 2 weeks ago. But I don't actually think Mikel Arteta will be quite as tactically naive as Ollie. So I think it'll be an entertaining 2-2 match with everyone's favourite frustrating footballer Patson Daka scoring to once again make me look like someone who eats slugs for lunch. Burnley versus Brentford. Brentford versus Burnley. This is almost a fight between good and evil, right? One team tries to stay in the league by being ambitious, trying to score through an attacking brand of entertaining football. The other copies the blueprint of Stoke. Aussie Burnley fans are being delighted with 17th every year, but lads, watching three corners and two shots on target every match. Aussie Burnley fans are probably delighted with 17th every year, but lads, watching two corners and three shots on target every match. Watching Dale Stevens eat seven Kit Kats on the bench. Is this really living? Again, Burnley haven't won a Premier League match since May. They haven't beaten a current Premier League team since April, when Chris Wood weirdly scored a first half hat-trick at Wolves. Lads, they haven't won a game at Turf Moor since late January. So that means the last time Burnley fans went to the stadium and saw their team won was beating Bournemouth in February 2020. That's nearly 2 years ago. If you don't beat Brentford this week, you're gonna have to wait until late November to end that miserable run. Burnley fans, paying for that season ticket this time out, it's like agreeing to buy a DVD box set of Mrs. Brown's Boys. It's like signing up to watch an expensive live stream of cats licking ice cream out of Johnny Vegas' belly button. No thanks. A Turf Moor season ticket costs £450. I hope the halftime pints are good. I hope the packets of Palm Bears are nice. I hope the toilets are clean so you can drink out of the bowl like a dog. Because otherwise, what's the point in going? I can only see a Brentford win here, an ambitious 2-0 win. Ivan Toney getting on the score sheet with Burnley fans ready to pull out their own eyes. Newcastle versus Chelsea. Yeah, I remember that game against Tottenham, which was supposed to be like the first post-takeover party. Yeah, no, that was pretty anticlimactic. I think everyone forgot that the Geordie defense was still about as sturdy as seven wet custard creams. I mean, Steve Bruce was still on the dugout. For most Geordies, that was like trying to celebrate their birthday party when their fat Uncle Pete is sitting in the corner. You know the one I'm talking about. But no, he's gone. Bruce is gone, and in his place is Graham Jones. Oh dear, a Luton Town failure versus a Champions League winning coach in Thomas Tuchel. Should we start digging Jones' grave already? I overestimated the power of the fans against Tottenham 2 weeks ago. Sure, it's a nice advantage, but the reality is, when you've got Kieran Clarke at the back and Joe Linton on the wing, it doesn't really count for much. I see nothing but a pretty simple 2-0 Chelsea win. Man City versus Crystal Palace. We just saw Patrick Vieira return to Arsenal with a point to prove. I mean, clearly still seething as having been overlooked for the job in favour of another former Arsenal midfielder who wound up as a Man City coach. And now Vieira is travelling to the Etihad, again probably annoyed at having been passed over for the management job at Man City. Despite everybody screaming what a promising coach he was, now instead he was banished to New York. Weirdly, Palace have a good record at this daunting ground. A 2-2 draw in January 2020, a 3-2 win in December 2018. That's 4 points and 5 goals across 2 matches here. That is fearless. You know what? I'm going to go for a shock here. I think there's going to be another match where Pep Guardiola has a tactical cough. Vieira will surprise him with an adventurous attacking lineup. Christian Benteke will stick them 1-0 up in the first half before Raheem Sterling rescues a late point. Yeah, I'll go for a 1-1 draw. City are going to win 5-0 now, aren't they? Liverpool versus Brighton. A few weeks ago, I said Liverpool were on a revenge mission to avenge last year's humiliations. I mean, Liverpool will remember Brighton taking advantage of their mishmash hamburger defence last February, turning up to Lee Anfield with a win. I mean, then Jordan Henderson partnering Nat Phillips in defence, but no mercy from Brighton. Nothing. It's a bit like punching a wheelchair-bound man in the face. I mean, no. Sorry, Brighton, but you are doomed. For a team proudly sitting 5th in the league, they haven't won any of the last 4 games, scoring just twice. Christ, well, they couldn't even find a goal against Norwich. This is going to be a 4-0 rout. Mo Salah will get another 2 goals. Honestly, for Graham Potter, this is going to be a painful afternoon. Watford versus Southampton. Okay, what just happened last week? This is what I said in my video about frustrating Premier League players last week.
Watford Josh King. Never mind Watford fans, Josh King must be frustrated with himself. If he ends the season with 0 goals, then he will have scored 0 league goals in 2 full seasons. seasons across three different clubs. That is beyond hideous. Only 3 years ago, he was scoring 12 goals in a Premier League season for Bournemouth. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer was desperately trying to bring him to Man United. There is ability in this Norwegian striker's boots. It's not as if he's some pasta fella winding down his career. He's only 29 years old, playing in 7 Premier League games a season, and registered a big fat nothing. I don't care if Erling Haaland has stolen your thunder as Norway's golden god. I don't care if he's probably replaced your face on billboards in the streets of Oslo and Bern. You are a man with nearly 50 Premier League goals in your CV. Where is your pride?
Of course, the man hadn't scored a league goals in 2020, spending 3 different clubs and half a year in the championship. And yet the moment I criticise him, oh, then he explodes with a hat-trick. Oh yeah, very nice, very wholesome. The minute I bring it to everyone's attention that Josh King has been an underwhelming lump of strawberry muffin as a centre-forward. Oh, then he morphs into peak Luis Suarez. I mean, what just happened to Everton were 2-1 up with just 12 minutes left? Imagine the toffees who left early to beat the traffic, switching on the radio and hearing that they somehow lost 5-2. They'd probably be close to swerving off a bridge. I am done with trying to predict Claudio Ranieri. 1 minute he loses to the Faroe Islands, the next he wins the Premier League with Danny Simpson at right back. He's only been in the job 2 weeks, and he's already seen his team score 5 and concede 7. It's just mental. So for this game, I've no idea. I'm gonna go with my gut. 3-0 Southampton. I mean, the Saints haven't lost in this ground since September 2007, so... yeah, what do they have to lose? Tottenham versus Man United. Okay, Man United fans, you don't deserve to be offended by this. Okay, you can't lose 5-0 home to anyone and be annoyed when I tip you to lose the next match. You can't concede 9 goals in 2 games. You can't take 1 point from a possible 12 and be annoyed when I think that you're going to lose again. And especially not against largely the same 11 players who turned up to Old Trafford a year ago to score 6. Listen, I know Tottenham have been ordinary pineapple pizza under Nuno Espirito Santo. I mean, make no mistake about it, they are a bang average team right now. But United are in free fall, I'm convinced. Ollie's lost the respect of the dressing room. I mean, he'll have lost confidence in himself. Sure, it's Ferguson could get away with having a team talk of,
"Lads, it's Tottenham."
But Solskjaer, little old Tottenham are going to lose you your job. I think this is going to be a famous 3-1 win for Tottenham, with Harry Kane, a Son and Min utterly chewing through Harry Maguire as if his legs were made of tinfoil. Tottenham was the setting for a Phil Jones disaster class 3 years ago. Well, here, be prepared. We're about to witness Maguire's worst game in a United shirt. Honestly, he's going to look like a walking and talking bread bin. Norwich versus Leeds. If Leeds United don't grind out a win here, then yeah, this is the time to panic. At this stage of a season, the Ellen Road faithful are probably so nervous, they'd probably gladly chuck their firstborn kid into a bin if it guaranteed them 3 points. Honestly, Leeds, what's going on? Second season syndrome isn't supposed to apply to Marcelo Bielsa. Now you're having to scrap for 94th minute equalizers at home to Wolves. But for Norwich, it's official. That club have lost sight of reality. They lose 7-0 to the champions of Europe, and then this happens.
Norwich City sporting director Stuart Webber calls Chelsea defeat disgraceful and embarrassing for fans.
Oh! Here's his nuggets of wisdom.
We are being unsuccessful now. That means we have 300 staff that need to do more and players that need to do more. For anyone who says we don't deserve to be at this level, that is wrong. I'm sorry, the man is doing mental gymnastics.
Almost to the point of a headache to avoid blaming Daniel Farke. I mean, apparently there's 300 staff that need to do more. Oh yeah, I'm sure the reason you're losing games is because of Sheila and Margaret serving up stale pudding in the canteen. I'm sure Joe the janitor isn't scrubbing toilets hard enough. How can Bill, who organises the car park, sleep at night, right? It's nonsense. The reason for this is your lack of investment and your continued belief in Daniel Farke. Oh, a man with what, 5 wins in 48 Premier League matches? How is he still in charge? He's an excellent championship coach. Yes, but another dog's dinner of a tactician when pitted against the big boys. Not to mention Farke, he hates Marcelo Bielsa with a blinding passion. Here he was moaning last season in the media.
Even when we won the league, I did not win Manager of the Year. Leeds won the title last year and Bielsa's nominated for Manager of the World.
But what are you moaning about? You won that award last season. Please don't draw comparisons to your teapot tactics to Bielsa. That man will be able to tactically confuse you using nothing but chunks of soggy Weetabix. Leeds and Norwich haven't played out a nil-nil since 1992. But yeah, I'm gonna go for it now. But only because Leeds are in such a miserable run of form. Otherwise, yeah, Bielsa would be able to unpick Norwich with his eyes closed. Aston Villa versus West Ham. Yeah, so this is 13th against 4th. You'd think it would be easy to predict, but not. This game could be anything. Listen, Villa have lost 3 games in a row, conceding 8 times in 3 games. Considering the money they spent, if this run lasts beyond Christmas, Dean Smith could be looking for a new job. I mean, don't get me wrong, he's done well. But give this squad to an attack-minded coach like Paulo Fonseca, Eddie Howe, or even Ronald Koeman, and we could be looking at a force next season. But for now, it's all got a bit stale. I'll go for a Mikel Antonio goal, a 1-0 West Ham win. So yeah, one goal on Super Sunday, you can almost guarantee Match of the Day 2 is going to be as exciting as watching your granddad a jumper out of her armpit hair. Anyway, that's the end of the video, lads. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think? If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and as always, I'll talk to you in a while.